a thread by soul war. East meets West, as Bezmenov's four phases of ideological subversion crashes into the Chinese Communist Party's six phases of warfare. To create the abject mess Americans are being forced to contend with. Please note, the origins of these subtle attacks on America as founded come from Marxism. Homework. Study those two previous picks. Drink them in. They explain how we were attacked over the last 60 years. Pat Scopolides' epic thread on General Flynn's interview is required reading to grasp what we are fighting against right now. Video on the same thread on this channel. Where the USSR floundered and the Chinese Communist Party is currently winning. Both nations have managed to stealthily put down Marxist roots on U.S. soil, something I never would have believed possible until Obama arrived. Everything was timed to occur under a Hillary presidency. Imagine the vile cancel culture BLM and Antifa running amok under President Clinton. Then the lockdowns from the pandemic with no world-class business leader to salvage our economy, no amazing hand coupling government and industry as allies to beat COVID in record time, saving lives. One man, our president and champion, has offset all of that. Six decades of our enemy's time, money, and energy that they have invested in our fundamental transformation is being unraveled in record time as President Trump works tirelessly to restore American stability. Demoralization is education, has been corrupted and now indoctrinates children, churning out broken minds and lost souls. A demoralized person has no boundaries they will defend. They will rationalize and excuse anything to be left alone. I didn't see nothing. He probably deserved it. That man was in the UK, which is now very different from Churchill's Britain. He's being arrested for not wearing a mask and protesting after he lost his small business. Ah, well, best to not get involved. He probably did something, you know. The pandemic was the crisis. The lockdowns are supposed to destroy our economy and thereby the middle class as well. The pandemic has been the greatest transfer of wealth in human history, as the small businesses crater and corporations thrive. You are to be left with nothing but the need to obey. No options. Now that the Democrats, the mainstream media, and Silicon Valley overlords believe they have successfully stolen the election and are installing their doddering puppet, they are making moves towards normalization to make cancel culture, critical race theory, and riots your new normal. They are arrogantly counting President Trump as finished and soon to be gone. Hey, it's not my fault they don't know Civics 101. President Trump gamed out how to win in 2016. He beat the Democrats' cheat then, and he's going to beat it now. I have zero doubts. He's got the receipts. So, as the left fights one another to see who will pull puppet Joe's strings, they aren't paying attention to what Trump is doing, having already written him off. Man, the hubris is just staggering. The bleak picture I'm painting is the second act in what I'm calling the Trump movie. Because the third act will blow your mind. Trump couldn't stop the Democrats from trying to steal the election, but now that they have, he has overwhelming amounts of hard evidence to overturn it and flip the key states they stole, as the mainstream media and social media demand that we bend the knee. So, you are about to see the 2018 midterms in reverse, as Trump flips states red, only this time by not ballot harvesting like the shady Democrats, but by having the illegal ballots tossed out, state by state. Watch it happen, as their charade morphs into a parade of fools. The press is now demanding Trump to leave office, admit defeat, and go away. Of course, the mainstream media frame what happened as Trump flipping out every day that goes by. Note, our elitist overlords are acting more and more frantic. Trump rewriting their movie. Newsmax tweets, in case you missed it. Don't ever talk to the president that way. Donald Trump goes off on a, quote, lightweight reporter while he and his team continue to challenge election numbers. Duane continues. He's utterly unfazed by the false reality they're trying to force him to accept. He never will, and you shouldn't either. This all comes down to objective versus subjective reality. The enemy is winning the PR war. You know, the war that doesn't matter? Wasted energy. Trump's energy is invested in the law. The court of law is where he's focused his energy. The number of people convinced by liars and deceivers means what exactly to a judge? Now we know why Trump and McConnell worked ceaselessly to fill those federal judgeships Obama left vacant. The mainstream media and the loony left are following a fantasy script. Trump is following the electoral process, you know? What the left tried to burn to the ground on election night, and our Constitution to the letter. I already know how this is going to play out, and so does General Flynn. We all have a role in this. Moving to the Chinese Communist Party's effort to destabilize and destroy our republic as founded, note what Mr. Scopoletti said. The first five phases of the six phases of Chinese warfare are all information. You're told every day your vote and your voice don't count. It's a lie. Why are the mainstream media and social media fighting so hard to contain relevant information while desperately impeding your ability to disseminate it? And at the same time, throwing out shit tons of fake news. Because you have always been their actual target. We have betrayed them. All that time and effort invested into our inevitable serfdom, where they can then safely abuse us to their dark heart's content as they endlessly complain about having to suffer our childish inadequacies. After ensuring those failings via poverty, indoctrination, and fear. Trump is simply in the way of their intentions towards us, and he's upsetting everything. His second term will replace their carefully created monstrosity with a highly efficient structure whose benefit will be astonishing. Not benevolent in itself, but very much so in the right hands. The control of information, the mind poison of the media, and the use of fear, Black Lives Matter and Antifa, has all been done to try and render you into confused, angry, and half-crazy basket cases. Look around you. Tell me I'm wrong. The fight has always been bigger than anyone realized. As we await Trump's coup de grace on the coup plotters, I'd like you to focus on this salient point. Who is looking and acting like the winner of November 3rd, and who isn't? The Biden administration is arranging deck chairs on the USS Democrat Party as she goes down amidships. They used terror tactics to get the General Services Administration to release funds. They're defying court orders as they destroy ballots and edit the software on voting machines in Georgia. If I know they're doing it, the Attorney General does too. It's a simple equation. They aren't going to stop until they are stopped. Remember, it was all or nothing, so they are going to reap the whirlwind like a dam bursting. The cracks come first, then the collapse, and then the flood. A flood of consequences they won't be able to shake off, causing a failure cascade that will ripple from here to Beijing. Unplug from the sewer pipe that is the mainstream media. Stop allowing people who despise you to manipulate you through the access you give them in the hopes of gaining information. They'll rob your potential and leave you awash in fear, anger, and doubt. We did our job. We voted and supported Trump. Real information is available through effort on the internet. Learn how to access it without the duplicitous sellout middlemen. You're being told every day that you don't matter. That's the American they want you to be. Be a real American. Fearless, relentless, and righteous like Trump. The real reason Trump will get his second term is because Americans won't settle for anything less than that the law and our Constitution are followed. It's playing out. When Trump looks worried and General Flynn does, then I'll be concerned. But I have faith in them. Trump, Flynn, Giuliani, and Powell are constants to me. They are consistent, and their reputations are rock solid for a reason. As the enemy lies ceaselessly, our fighters gather those lies for the reckoning. That building tension you're feeling, it's not coming from our side. We're fine. We're going to be fine. I'm preparing for an amazing Christmas as the draconian overlords in blue states are no doubt preparing to cancel it as their power fractures over people who are regaining their Americanism. Link in the thread, November 23rd, Phenomenosophy tweets, business owners versus COVID bureaucracy. Business owners in Buffalo, New York demand health inspector and sheriff's deputies leave private property. Go get a warrant. People have had enough of the COVID-19 tyranny curbing their life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If you haven't seen the video, link in the thread, you must check it out. Dwayne continues, catch the red wave. Surf your way to knowledge. Stop using the media to inform you. Use media to show you what's happening by realizing why false narratives are being presented. It's a skill. Build it and expand on it. Then stand with Trump and what he's defending. From Plato, the first and greatest victory is to conquer yourself. To be conquered by yourself is of all things most shameful and vile. To support the works of Dwayne Cates, donate any amount at paypal.me/Brent Cates. Also check out the Americana Rising Teespring store, link in the thread.
I will be the greatest president that God ever created.